Welcome to the Docklands in the heart of Melbourne. Docklands is fast gaining a reputation as one of Australia's best and most challenging brim fisheries. Here in the shadows of the Balti Bridge and Etihad Stadium, some fantastic land-based fishing for one of our prime sports fish. I'm Ross Gould and I've been fishing here for a long time now, and I'd like to show you a sneaky hard body vibe technique using micro vibes. Land-based fishing in the Docklands is easy. There's plenty of parking, you don't have to worry about launching a boat, plus you can sneak up on the fish and they've got no idea where you're coming from. My personal preference, I use a high visibility frog PE braid. This is 4 pound, it's an 8-strand braid. Strike Pro Micro Vibe, it's tied onto 4 pound Harris Fighter fluorocarbon. Daiwa Infeet 2004 sized reel with a finesse drag, and a 1 to 3 kilo spinning stick in 7 foot. It's a two-piece, just makes it easier to get on and off the train or out of the car when you're coming down here. So basically what we've got here is about 12 meters of water. A lot of vertical structure, a lot of vegetation on it. You're looking at a lot of mussels. So what we're just trying to do here is use a very small sinking hard body to work very close to the structure. Try and get a reaction bite out of one of these brim. So it really comes down to light lines, keeping an eye on what you're doing, what your line's doing, how your lure's moving as it falls through the water column. Added advantage is that you can work these on the way back up and down, although 90% of the hits that you do get are going to come while the lure is dropping. So it's really a matter of just keeping an eye. Oh, just missed one there. Just keeping an eye on your line. If it speeds up, generally means that a fish has taken it and it really wants it. If the line stops dropping, and you know you're fishing in about 12 metres of water and it's gone down about 6, it means it's sitting in something's gob. That's when you want to give it a bit of a strike, see if you've got an interested brim. If you do, in this sort of country, you're going to be fairly up against it, so you want to move fairly quickly, try and get it out of there, and not bust your rod in half on all these lovely pylons and bits of wharf here. This hard body vibe technique works on any vertical structure, not just in the Docklands, but any port, wharf or marina in Australia. So no matter where you are, if you're fishing land-based for brim in deep water, next to vertical structure, this technique could catch you a fair share of brim. Just on a pylon here, the reason for that is the fish tend to congregate around it, looking for food, for a bit of cover, and as well these pontoons, they do offer them a bit of shade and a bit of protection from above. There's quite a few cormorants around this area. Like to have a pick at the brim, so anywhere where they tend to feel safe and feel like they can feed fairly openly, that's sort of where you want to be. Get in on top of them, present them something hopefully that looks fairly tasty. So basically what we've got here is hard body vibe technique. The particular vibe I'm using here is called a micro vibe. Very small lure, weighs only a couple of grams. Basically what we're looking to present to the fish here is a wounded bait fish, even one that's been smashed in half, just falling down along the pylon, which they're generally feeding on mussels. So just hoping to get some attention from a fish that's already in that feeding mode. Basically laying the line out onto the top of the water here using a very high visibility braid. And that just allows me to see how fast the line's sinking. If that pauses or starts to sink quite a bit faster than what it's meant to, generally mean there is a fish on the end of that, and you want to get a strike in fairly quickly. Set these hooks, they're very fine gauge hooks, so they'll pin a fish almost every time, but you're going to want to get the fish up fairly quickly. They're not going to last too long on these hooks. So it's paused there. Basically, from the drop that it's gone through, I'd say that is the bottom, but give it a strike anyway. you can spend a little bit of time just sitting on the bottom there, giving it a few twitches. The lure gives off a very strong vibration for its size, so it should attract fish to the area. Hopefully they'll spot it. Yep, on. Okay. Now, this one's only taken it a couple of metres down, so we'll just lift this guy out. Now, get down here. He's pinned fairly well, so I'll just lift him out on the leader. Now, he's just been pinned in the bottom lip there. As you can see, two trebles finding home this time, which is nice. Always much more comfortable when there's two in the jaw as opposed to just the one. And he'll go back to fight another day. Just another great little Docklands Bream, pulled off this pylon right here. So again, seeing these lures work exceptionally well on vertical structure. So might get this fella back in and try and catch one of his mates. All right, so we'll just get these trebles out. There we go, he's free. So just get him back into the drink. He slipped away nice and easy. Well, let's try and catch some more. All right, so I'm just gonna sneak up quietly here. These stairs are traditionally an area where we found some very large bream cruising around. So always worth dropping a lure down. Quite a bit of vegetation on these steps, so always worth putting something down there. Now, a lot of bream fishers will be wondering why I'm not using a lightly weighted or mid-weighted soft plastic to try and get bream out of here. It's certainly something that you can use, and it's proven. My preference is to go for a hard body. I just feel the action that it has on the drop. This has got a really tight shimmy on the drop, and as well the fact that we're sitting in an area with 12 metres of water means that I can really feel connected to what this lure is doing. Those 12 metres down, I can feel the vibration of the lure as it lifts off the bottom. You know, I just have a personal preference, not to say that soft plastics don't work around here, they absolutely do. So, you can see some small bream here. Just picking away at the vegetation. So just drop that down ever so quietly. Hopefully get some interest. And then you got guys like Felix who'll just pop one right over the top of you.
No.
Add to the degree of difficulty.
This is Ravine technique. Won't catch a line.
Refined technique there. Yeah.
To be annoying fishermen, basically.
Now be aware when you're fishing at the Docklands, there are some privately owned pontoons. Some you can fish from, some you can't. This one has no signs, but if I was asked to leave, I would. There we go, fish. There we go. All right. That's a better fish. Right to the micro vibe technique. Just pulled him off this pylon here. Interestingly, he just shot straight out into open water. So we're able to pull him in fairly easily. So what we'll do is we'll just have a look at this fish and see how he's hit that. So this one's actually been pinned right inside the mouth with those trebles. As I said, look, these ultra sharp trebles, they only need to get a hint of a fish's mouth and they'll pin them. So he's had a fair go at that one there. Okay, so basically with this, pegged it in really nice and close to both the pontoon and this pylon here. Let the lure drop, just watching the slack line. Again, had a couple of twitches on the slack line, and then all went a bit still. At that point, decided, okay, fish is on here. Gave it a bit of a strike, and yep, certainly fish was on. Fortunately, just shot out into open water, so able to get him in fairly quickly, and yeah, nice little fish. All right, so we've pulled that fish out of here. Look, it's really not uncommon to pull up to half a dozen fish off the one bit of structure. And the conditions are right in this area, obviously, for a fish to eat this lure, so we'll just get these lures straight back in there and hope that another one falls for the same trick again. Yeah, he's good. Alright. So, he's just come right off that pylon there. Really interested in this lure. Alright, so we just got him up here. Now, I don't know if you can see, we're about 2.5 metres from the water here. So a cradle lift is not going to happen. So we're going to have to walk him down, hopefully get him onto one of these pontoons. So one of the dangers of fishing around the docks is that you've got to do this a fair bit. After a while, you get used to taking your fish for a walk. So just try and keep his head up a bit here so he doesn't put a run in. Hopefully get him down here. So just using the rod as a bit of a shock absorber here. All right, I'll just swim him into you, mate.
Oh, he's just been, it's perfect.
All right, you want to just see if you can grab him there, mate?
Yep.
That's beautiful, thank you. Behaving himself, which is nice. That one's just pinned him there. So really, the way we've caught this fish typifies the docks. Casting in tight to some really heavily vegetated area. Just using polarized sunglasses to spot the fish. Getting in there a nice light presentation. Fishing these little blades or vibes alongside these pontoons and pylons. So that's basically what we're talking about. When we come down to the docks, we're looking to use these little vibes to catch these bream here. And as you can see, and what we've demonstrated today, it's a deadly combination. They're suckers for these little offerings. And look, it's great fun coming down here, right on the doorstep of one of Australia's biggest capital cities, and to be able to throw around these small lures and catch these fantastic Australian bream. You can't ask for much more than that.